Cryptoeconomics is a relatively new research field. And it's not just a research field, but it's an applied science of mathematics, of game theory, and also the combinations of cryptography, distributed systems, and general purpose economics as well. And so really, cryptoeconomics probably started around the days of Ethereum back in 2014, when you now had more applications and more connectivity at the user level or at the retail level of how and why people interact together. Typically in Web2, you have mostly two-sided marketplaces where you have a producer and seller of a good software product, and then you have the user that buys and utilizes that same product. But in Web3, you more have a three-sided marketplace where not only you have the buyer, the seller, the creator, that typically, and that buyer and seller and creator of product is usually also the stakeholder and the shareholder, but now you enable users to become the shareholder and the stakeholder automatically through the interaction with that product, with that data, and with that combination. And so cryptoeconomics and crypto tokens enable everyday users and everyday people to have a share, to have a say, to be a stakeholder in these environments, which you couldn't necessarily do or didn't have the proper incentives to build in Web2 or centralized constructs before. Hi, my name is Mike McCoy. I'm the ecosystem lead of the CryptoEconLab at Protocol Labs. Incentives and structures in crypto networks and crypto ecosystems are very important. A lot of times people will build tokens, build economies, build networks, but they have a purpose that maybe they have a use case, or maybe they have a target set of users they want to optimize for, whether it's with data, whether it's with storage, whether it's with new financialization tools like staking or utilizing DeFi, etc. But they may not have the actual scientific method and the data and the math behind creating that environment properly, or understanding how it may grow both in a positive manner or in a negative manner as well. At the CryptoEconLab, we help startups, venture portfolios, protocols, foundations, and leaders of these ecosystems understand their goals and how their protocol actually works. In doing that, we go from the very basics of what are your goals, what are the actual things you want to accomplish over a certain amount of time. We then help fine-tune parameters for you. And so if you want a parameter of understanding, we have 10,000 users. And if we grow that to 20,000 users or to 100,000 users, what does the actual token economy look like there? What do the users have to do to increase the actual value or the circulating supply? If you have a mint rate, what does that mint rate actually go towards? If I'm actually minting a certain amount of token, am I losing the value of it? Am I losing the value accrual of it? Those are things we can measure out with the tools and the team that we have put in place. Also, in the similar fashion of burning. If you burn your currency, if you burn your token, if you're burning data storage from the actual network, how does that affect what you do with the users at a long-term basis? We measure this out through simulations and models. So we will create custom agent-based models. A lot of times we'll have them focus on a specific goal, so they'll become goal-oriented agent-based models. And in there, in your simulation, you can understand when you hit that certain parameter, if I have 10,000 users, I have 1 million circulating supply, and I want to be able to get to a point where I have 10 million tokens, and maybe more users, what those different dynamics will look like over time. And this is so important because your tokenomics are the foundation of why and how you build out your protocol. Cryptoeconomics are very useful for investors, for people who run protocols, for token holders, and developers who want to continue to do activity in these Web3 native environments. You may need cryptoeconomics when you want to understand, is me holding this token valuable for a certain time? Is me being part of this protocol or foundation or network useful for the digital acts I want to do in the world? You may also want the economics to understand, are my actions in this network valuable? Are the people and the users and the companies and the partnerships I have in this valuable and not only providing monetary value, but social value, as well as technical value, as well as making things easier for developers to interact in these environments? And cryptoeconomics measure that out in many different ways. It also helps define technical complexity and understanding gas economics, for example. So one thing within crypto and protocol networks is gas is the thing that measures your compute. And there's a whole gas economy where a lot of times you're measuring compute of hash power, of proofs, of a whole lot of other things. And then you need to separate that out for How much are we charging this for everyday people to continue this network or this protocol to last and grow? And a lot of times we do the research in those economics in particular of understanding why it's valuable to take out a certain percentage from the network for security purposes, for financialization purposes, for liquidity purposes. And so if you're an investor, you're a holder, you're a person in these environments, you may want to know some of these very deep details and understanding why it's beneficial for you to be part of the network. There's been about 3 billion in DeFi hacks that happened in 2022. A lot of people got burned in Terra Luna's collapse, FTX's collapse, and some of the things that they didn't understand because they held their crypto in a centralized exchange and they trusted that just like they trust a bank. And now the trust has been damaged. The CryptoEconLab, one of our main goals is to really bring that trust back, make this less of a vague space, and to help people understand economics and how and why and where it's safest to utilize crypto, utilize tokens, and where the real value lies. And I want to be part of teams and part of these structures that help make that a lot simpler and easier for everyday people. And so the CryptoEconLab takes this broad, somewhat complex field of crypto, technology, finance, and economics, and we make it digestible for everyday people to not only trust crypto a little bit more, but to build and create incentives in crypto also. So the CryptoEconLab started officially in 2019 and really built out the Filecoin economy, really building out, as I mentioned, like circulating supply, how we mint, how we burn, how we vest in tokens, and how we have this utility of data storage and compute and then getting paid for it on top with this financialization type of tool and metric. Those were early days of accomplishment to be able to enable a token launch in 2020 for Filecoin to utilize their economy and to utilize their tokens. Within our 9 core team members, we have 5 of us that have PhDs in either economics, data science, or physics, and a rigorous mathematical background, and a lot of fun actually going through some of these difficult problems and equations that startups and protocols and foundations always run into when it comes to, well, how many actually tokens should I have in the circulating supply? How much should I actually use to pay for storage? And what is the actual utility of storage? What is it worth globally? Starting at the end of 2022 into 2023, since we have such a robust team and a huge core of excellent research scientists, we expanded our work, not just only working within Protocol Labs network startups and within the Filecoin economy. We're looking to really help out DeFi economies, layer 2 economies, ZK chains as well. And those are some of the newer projects, but L1s and the economics and the economies along them are all the ones we like to assist and support. And so today, we are a group that not only works and continues to create and enhance the Filecoin economy, we are doing it with other ecosystems and other institutions and other financial environments in the future too.